Hi folks, Artist Mac here, back with another exciting episode of What the Clutch. What I'm doing is taking out the clutch pedal assembly and the clutch master cylinder. And what I'm doing here is bleeding the clutch system to get fluid out of the lines up front so it doesn't spill out when I have to disconnect it from the clutch master cylinder. If you've watched the previous installments, you have seen me try to diagnose exactly what was wrong with my clutch system. What I'm going to do in this episode is to remove the clutch master cylinder and the clutch pedal assembly. It's one of the aluminum ones that was having a problem in, well, all Fieros it was installed in, with bending back. The first step is getting the rod that attaches to the master cylinder off of that pin that comes out of the clutch pedal assembly. And the first step in doing that is to get the retention clip out of the hole that it's in on the clutch pedal assembly pin. It's not as easy as I'm making it look, ha ha ha, but eventually it came out. Then there'll be a washer next to the rod banjo. Take that out. And then you can take the banjo off of that pin. There'll be another very small, small, thin washer on the inside. You'll also need to take that off. Next, disconnect the fluid line from the master cylinder. And let's see. Will it come out? There it goes. Wow. Look at the sludge in that cylinder. What a mess. Looks like used motor oil. Now to take out the master cylinder retention nuts. Gotta get a light on it here. Okay, there's one. And I think you can see the other. Yeah, I'm pointing to it right there. They both have to come off to get the master cylinder out. And it's gonna be some work. Okay, here's one nut. Just gotta get the other. And now the master cylinder can come out of the place it has been for the last 34 years. Boy. Yeah. I think this was ready to be replaced. Cause that's just gunk down in there. There's the new one, ready to go in. And there's the cap. Yep. Not gonna put it in just yet, I'm just fitting it. But yep, it'll go in just fine. Why is he filing the paint off that pin, I hear you ask? Because the hole in the banjo on the new master cylinder is just a little too small to fit on the pedal. Filing off the paint got it halfway on. Drilling the banjo hole to the correct diameter got it all the way on. Okay, so this little washer goes on first, then there we go, then goes the banjo, and then goes the washer. Ran over to Ace Hardware and got one that was the right size, as opposed to this one, which was just slightly too small. And then I'm not going to put it on now because I don't want to stress it, but this clip goes in, I don't know if you can see it. I think you can see it now. There's a hole right there. Where is it? Yeah, right there. And that's where this clip goes in. So anyway, everything fits like a glove. It goes back and forth just like it's supposed to. All right. Once I get the old pedal out, and get everything put in, brand new. I must apologize to the publishers of the official Fiero service manual. They did include a diagram for the neutral safety switch, where it is, and exactly how to disconnect the electrical connections. They do not show how to disconnect it from the pedal. Thanks! Okay, and you want to disconnect the neutral safety switch. I've already pulled out this little I don't know what you call it. A lever. But anyway, just pull it out. And it's out. Now, you have to get the safety switch off of its attachment, because it's not actually attached to the pedal. And I'm going to try to move it up here and show you. Yeah, I think you can see it there. Anyway, it's a hex head screw and you're gonna have to get it out. Either with a screwdriver handle socket remover or with a socket wrench. Your choice. After a great deal of experimentation, it turns out you will need a 7mm socket to get that neutral safety switch off of its attachment bracket. You're welcome. I don't know if you can see it there, but there. Oh my god. Yeah, there we go. Now it's in the middle. That is the bolt you have to get off to get the clutch pedal out. And that's about the best view I can get of it. In fact, you're pretty much gonna have to do this by feel, because that neutral safety switch is not going anywhere, because once I get the pedal out, I'm gonna have to figure out how that switch is attached. I don't even know if you can see what's happening here, but I've got my socket wrench. I've got about a 2-inch extension, and I've got a 15mm socket on this bolt that is holding the clutch pedal on. And I'm loosening it. Not much else to tell you. I can't move any of these wires. But you see that silver thing? That is the shaft that is holding, well, part of the shaft anyway, that is holding both the brake pedal and the clutch pedal in place. And you see, no, I can't get my hand in there. You see that bolt? You see how much it's come out there? That's because I gave a little tap on the other end where the nut was holding it on there. Oh my god, wait a minute. Yeah, okay, there we are. Yeah, I gave a little tap, and so it came partially out. What I'm gonna do, I'm either gonna try prying it from this end, or If that doesn't work, I'm going to try tapping the other side that had the nut. You know, just very lightly tapping it with an awl. Just enough so that the pedal, the clutch pedal, I should say, can come out. So that's where I'm at right now. I can't hold the camera and do that, but this should come out far enough so that the clutch pedal either drops down or I can pull it down. Okay. Back to work. You see that spring? That is going to be your problem. Because there is a section there where it goes into that bracket. And that has got to be, well, from what I've read on Pinnix, that's what keeps it from coming out. Now, one guy said that he just took the thing out with a Dremel. I still have not seen these two bolts that they're talking about that you can loosen to get this thing out. Have not seen them yet. But anyway, I'm gonna try prying that with a screwdriver and see if that works. But, I mean, I've got the bolt all the way back, and and it's wobbling. It's just not coming out. Now, I've tried bending that spring back with a screwdriver, you know, like I was saying, but it just does not want to come out. I mean, the only way I can see to get it out is to do what the guy on Pinnix was saying and use a Dremel on it and basically destroy it to get it out. So I want to get your opinions, people in the Fiero community who have replaced clutch pedals before. Am I going to need that spring for the new clutch pedal installation? I mean, as near as I can see, there isn't even any place you could put it on there. You know, I got the two bushings, they're in both sides. But am I gonna need that spring? So, Matt. So, if you can write me back in the comment section, I'd really appreciate it. And if I get more, just Dremel it. And, oh no, you must save it. I'll just go on ahead and destroy it. But, I mean, that's where I am right now. I mean, I've got the bolt out, and I'm pulling on that pedal, and it's just not coming down. Okay. This is Artist Mac, for now, signing off. Say goodbye.